another bauble that means so very much to me. It's a present from a very dear friend. As you can see, it's a globe and it shows all the continents, all those land masses, seas and oceans. I quite like seeing the globe in that small tennis ball size, because when you think of the size of the Earth set in the universe, it's just so tiny, so very small, and yet full of detail, full of life, full of the glory of God, as indeed the universe is. It's a reminder to me that I love to travel and I love learning about different cultures and cuisines. I was very fortunate to have parents who appreciated food and culture. My mum was an amazing cook, and as children growing up, we shared our home with foreign, I suppose you'd say overseas now, students. And they came from as far afield as Thailand, the Ivory Coast, and as near as France and Spain. Mealtimes were full of excitement and our table was always interesting. The conversation was always interesting. The food was always interesting. And my mum passed on to all her children a love of cooking and sharing of cultures and cuisines. What a diverse world we live in. The globe reminds me too of the importance of praying for the needs of the world. And at this moment, there are needs common to all the nations. A vaccine is needed by everybody, by rich countries and poor countries alike. The church has a huge part to play in this, and it's worth remembering that although there are different denominations and styles, Jesus has only one church and one bride. And while we're waiting for his return, there's work to be done. What might that be? Well, in one sense, it's really easy. All of us have the same instructions, which he stated so very clearly in Matthew's Gospel. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. The best bit is he didn't just tell us what to do. He showed us how to do it by the way he lived his life on earth.